Welcome to the stream. I am operating
I've
on no
risen.
Sleep.
Hello.
I think my computer just hates me right now. I'm giving up on loading the stream so I can look at chat.
Oh no.
Y'all are gonna have to tell me what chat says.
Alright, I will tell you what chat says. I'm gonna go bully our friends to get in here.
Guys! Oh my god, they add them as we meet them.
As they befriend them.
Yeah. As we befriend them. Oh, if we kill them, they would not.
Yeah. Oh my god! Hi, Em. Sorry for lying to you about when we started. I am a very professional streamer.
It's 8-ish.
It's
not a loose 7
o'clock. It happens.
It'll be there. 7:16 where I am.
Here we go.
Get time zone. Checkmate.
Get time.
Try to remember. Oh right, I need to go back to the elevator.
Yeah, it's up.
Up. Because it's spider time.
It's spider time.
Oh yeah, it is spider time.
I love the spider so much.
The spider bakes.
Oh, the spider bakes though. I feel like last week.
Faye, can you move your mouse?
No.
Thanks.
The way that the aesthetic of the elevator is what makes me most is like weirdly what like is the most off influenced part to me, like aesthetically, I don't know why.
God, I love off.
So is this made? Was off made?
Yes, before.
No, off predates.
Oh, right. Second, like in 2007, it just like became popular. Had a resurgence.
It was like 2013 or something.
Yeah. Who wants to be spider?
Interested in spider pastries?
You need to do something about that mic cutting out.
This is just not close enough to mic.
Oh, sorry. All seeds go to real spiders. Check out the webs to make a purchase.
Ah, the interwebs.
Oh,
no. Infinite
expensive.
Money.
Extremely expensive.
Don't you care about our spiders' future? Don't you care about the future of spiders?
This guy is thinking about how expensive a donut he just bought.
Hi, Alf is here. This room is like the room we saw before.
Oh my god, Novi, hi.
Novi,
hi. Welcome to chat.
Fucking shout out to Novi.
There are two puzzles to the north and south. You'll solve them both to proceed. So I'd like to say I don't really like giving away puzzle solutions. But if you need help, just call me, okay? Actually, wait, I have an idea.
Oh no, an idea.
Let's be friends on Undernet. Then you can just ping me when you need help. It's so much easier than like talking to you on the phone. It's so embarrassing.
Her brilliant plan to not get called on the phone.
Wait, we're already friends, aren't we? I signed you up, didn't I? You've been reading my posts the whole time. Well, I hope you agree with me about Mew Mew 2.
Actually, I think Mew Mew 2 is a logical progression of Mew Mew's character arc.
You fucker, this was fan service.
I wanted you to talk to the guy who was holding the donut.
Oh, okay. I will go talk to Donut.
The guy having a life crisis.
Donut life crisis.
Yeah, he looks like he's having a life crisis. I ended up buying a donut.
So true.
Me too.
I didn't want to, but that girl, even though I told her no, she kept staring at me in this creepy way and licking her lips. Now I'm out of cash. Alright. Maybe I can sell it online and double my money back?
You got upsold.
No. I can't. can't
believe good fucking
was,
luck.
I can't believe he was doing NFTs.
Yeah, no, listen, if you look at it, if there's somebody who's staring at you, looking like they want to eat you, and menacingly, like, licking their lips, that's, like, a good thing, actually.
That's flirtation.
Yeah, that's called a fun time. I don't know why you're a coward, but...
Hey... This doesn't have anything to do with guiding you, but... Hey, would you want to watch a human TV show together? Sometime? It's called, Mew Mew Kissy Cutie. Really? It's so good. It's, my favorite show. It's all about this human girl named Mew Mew who has cat ears, which humans don't have, so she's a little sensitive about them. But, like, eventually, she realizes that her ears don't matter, that her friends like her despite the ears. It's really moving. Spoilers. Although this sounds weird, but she has the power to control the minds of anyone she kisses. She kisses people and controls them to fix her problems. They don't remember anything after the kiss, I mean. But if she misses the kiss, then... And, of course, eventually she realizes that control people... Okay, well, I almost spoiled the whole show, but, I think you'd really like it.
To be clear...
Are you trying to convince people to watch things?
Mood. Mood. Also, to be clear, I was not pushing any buttons for that. That is just...
Yeah, I know.
I just really like how it
I can keep up with it all! I'm used to info dubbing!
August beloved.
August, you're so good.
We should watch it. After you get through all this.
Assuming I don't die.
Assuming you don't die.
Wait, oh no, I'd almost gotten it.
Did almost have it.
I believe it. What?
The great part about, not having played Undertale in a while is completely forgetting all of the puzzle solutions.
It's a new game now.
Yeah, it's a can experience it anew.
Let's say that's what's happening.
Roll these vlogs. This is an immersive experience. It's like, me playing Borderlands 2 earlier. I was stuck on a, not even stuck. I was on this puzzle for like 15 minutes, and it turns out there was another switch I just didn't notice.
That's so funny.
I was like, I've tried every possible cover. Oh, wait, fuck.
Not that one.
Ha!
Hey!
You're right, Em. That is you and me talking about Fate, including the desperate need to spoil the whole plot to justify why the fuck any of this is happening.
It's like, listen. I know it looks weird, but if you think about it...
I swear to God
it's explained. It's not a plot hole, guys. Guys, it's not a plot hole.
Shout out to that time that the three of us, Faye and Em and me, were all at a restaurant together, and they were just like explaining Yu-Gi-Oh to me.
Okay.
Yu-Gi-Oh is
canon.
Sometimes I think about getting into Yu-Gi-Oh. I feel like I've seen interesting things. But
yes,
also,
Yu-Gi-Oh is a
I
show.
I mean, aren't you gonna be forcibly got into Yu-Gi-Oh soon?
Oh, yes I am. Actually, a certain kind.
Look, Yu-Gi-Oh is a show about the power of friendship and how the power of friendship is actually fucking terrifying.
The power of friendship and this gun I found.
Really good fanfic.
I keep meaning to read it. Because it sounds really good.
That's an excellent graphic.
Yeah, no, it's just entered the culture lexicon.
Yes, there is an ancient ghost who helps with the... There are multiple ancient ghosts who help with the card games.
Oh some my god, them... you had it!
You had the puzzle you and then you had it. It!
Oh no, I wasn't paying attention!
So sad.
I was looking at chat and just pushing random buttons.
Hey!
I'm a professional, shut up.
You're so professional. I love you very much.
Thank you. I appreciate you too.
Oh, I have played Yuki once with Coda.
It feels like
you did it again!
What?
Yeah!
No, I only have one. I feel it. I only have one.
No, you literally did it. You did it twice.
There was a blank. There was a full blank.
There was a blank. There was a blank.
No!
Twice, Faye.
I need to stop talking about Yu-Gi-Oh!
You clearly, this is the problem here. Too powerful.
Okay.
Guys, Gwyn is so talented.
What did Gwyn do?
They're drawing right now.
Hell yeah.
Doodle
book. Ah! Yes!
I had a moment of severe fear there.
That's so bad. You're gonna have to digitally edit this shit on this.
Oh my god. Wait, no, I need a better name. My fave Metaton moment, TM. Right when everything looks the baddest, he poses dramatically. Like when he's on a cooking show and the eggs don't turn out right.
I feel
also squares are sexy.
I feel unsettled by faces.
My favorite time moment TM is when he beats up the heel turning villain. Even if it's during what's supposed to be a quiz show, but like hey, fuck it, man.
I was gonna say, like, isn't he like a real life celebrity, not like
yeah, he's hey, don't worry about it.
He's both.
I can't believe that Metaton predicted the Dream SMP.
Wait, that's so true.
God.
And also the complete and total abrogation of personal and character boundaries created by the fact that the Dream SMP was wildly disorganized.
If it had just been a D&D game from the start, nobody would have had any issues. That's not true. God. I'm sure two would have had issues.
There would have been infinite issues.
There would have been different issues.
Yeah, it would have been different issues. Anyway, no, the thing that was fun to me about the D&D characters was that it reminded me of back towards at the beginning of the Night Vale when just Cecil was Cecil.
I remember that!
Apparently that was a coincidence, which delights me.
Not really.
Meanwhile, we can totally make fun of John Sims for it.
Yeah, yep. And then repeat, and then it came. Honestly,
why did John Sims do that?
Honestly, I thought it was an homage at first. It was not an homage.
He's just like, I think the main character should be the same name as me. And nothing like, related.
He's like, also my singing future space boy. Also, he has the same name.
He's so good. Extremely, extremely fun. Yet. Well, extremely.
He's like, I'm gonna have eight characters named Michael because it's true to life.
Yep,
and it is true to life.
It is true to life.
Extremely adjective fact. Uh-huh. One of the people who survived, he's dead now, who survived the longest with basically human mad cow disease was named Jonathan Sims, but with a different number of M's.
Holy shit.
Huh.
They said a human wearing a striped shirt will come through.
The more you know.
I would say it was an homage, but it wasn't his real name.
heard that they hate spiders. I heard they love to stomp on them. I heard that they like to tear their legs off. Look, just because I didn't have $1,000, I heard that they're awfully stingy with their money. Oh, yeah, that's you. Sorry.
Yes, our money that we don't have.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You think your taste is too refined for our pastries, don't you, dearie? I disagree with that notion. I think your taste is exactly what the next batch needs.
Ah, yes, the Girl Scouts are here, and they're going to beat the shit out of you.
Also, since you mentioned Welcome to Night Vale, here's some moth lore. I thought that Welcome to Night Vale made up Arby's for multiple years until I saw one in person.
Wait, that's so funny.
Is it because of we have the meats? That doesn't seem like a real tagline, you're right.
I think purple is a better look on you.
Love to be purple.
Hehe. Love for purple to be an act of parasitism.
Good music. Ooh, it is good music.
Look, the spiders are helping.
Oh, next. It's Little Miss Muffet.
Why so pale? You should be proud.
A generic Gawain sexy woman voice.
Proud, you're going to make a delicious cake.
This is one of my favorite songs in all of Undertale, to be honest.
It is a good banging song.
It is. Something about words to it, right?
Ooh.
I feel like I've heard this lyricized.
Also, the music is diegetic.
I feel like it should be like black and yellow, black and yellow, black and yellow, black and yellow.
Your soul is going to make every spider very happy.
Damn, what did they put in this?
Muffet pours you a cup of spiders.
Oh, how rude of me. I almost forgot to introduce you to my pet. It's breakfast time, isn't it? Have fun, you two.
Those are so many more of your pets.
No, those are her children.
Oh, right. Oh, God.
Bad.
What the fuck? It's a muffin. It's a spider. It's a spider muffin. It's a spuffin.
Hanging out at the spider, hanging out at the muffin, hanging out at the
combination spider muffin!
Honestly, I'd rather avoid it.
The person who warned us about you. Sorry.
Ooh, who warned them about
you? A lot of money for your soul.
To send all of my kids to college!
All of her 8,000 million billion... spawn.
Do you ever think about that one insult that's like, I hope your wife gives birth to a centipede and you have to spend your life slaving away to buy its shoes?
No, but now I will.
I think about that so often.
Oh my god.
It's such a good insult.
That's so good.
Not even insult, it's such a good curse.
Yeah, it is. Mm-hmm.
Such a sweet smile, and...
It's just really evocative.
It's strange, but I swore I saw them in the shadows, changing shape.
Why are you taking money from them?
I just love money.
As long as I get paid, I don't care.
It's lunchtime, isn't it? And I forgot to feed my pet.
Man, how did I ever beat Undertale?
Because you're good at video games.
I'm not good at video games.
You're good enough to beat Undertale.
Damn.
Really makes you think. That money. Spider. Excited.
Hi, Ab.
Upsamu! I can't see the chat right now because my computer hates me. But hi. No, I wanted to say,
I'm also clapping to the music. The spiders are correct on this one.
The spiders are correct. One of my favorite things about streaming is that I get to capture moments that, like, otherwise wouldn't be captured. Like, there is a Klausim stream in which I discovered that I really like using bows in Minecraft. And I'm really, really glad that that got, like that's saved. I have video footage of that.
Yeah!
Yeah!
It makes me really happy.
Home movies!
You haven't heard? Spiders have been trapped in the ruins for generations.
You and everyone else, buddy!
She hasn't noticed. Even if they go under the door, Snowden's fatal cold is impassable alone.
Yeah, but they're trapped in a smaller space.
That's true.
Yeah.
That's fair.
A smaller and different space.
Mm-hmm. Less popular. Suddenly, so tragic. Deep. But with soul, the rent and a heated limo. Yeah, I feel like Asgore should, or not, Azrael. Should,
No, you were right!
Asgore. I feel like Asgore should pay more attention to the needs of
all right,
citizens.
Y'all, I'm eating the ab quiche.
Ab quiche.
Build a spider baseball field.
Build a spider baseball field.
If you build it, they will come.
To specify to spider man, like spiders only,
spider size. But enough for that. It's time for dinner, isn't it?
Spider Machoke.
Swinging the spider man.
Yeah.
Om nom nom.
Crunch.
Wrong. Crunch. Still alive. Oh, my pet. Looks like it's time for dessert.
These are so many meals to eat in such a short time.
Oh, telegram from the spiders in the ruins? What? They're saying that they saw you and you helped donate to their cause. Oh my, this has been a big misunderstanding.
Hi, Jasper, whoever you are.
Hello, welcome to Undertale. I thought you were someone that hated spiders. The person who asked for that soul. They must have met a different human in a striped shirt. I can't believe I've let my prejudices blind me. Sorry for all the trouble. I'll make it up to you. You can come back anytime. For no charge at all. I'll wrap you up. Oh, sorry. I'll wrap you up and let you play with my pet again. Just kidding. I'll spare you now.
Oh boy.
Bye.
I earned 0 XP and 0 gold.
That was fun. See you again, dearie.
I love boss fights where they're like, this is a game to them, they are having fun, and they don't care if you win because, like, hey, sometimes you lose the game.
Yeah.
Look like it's almost time for the performance.
Tragic tale.
Moth, are you ready for this?
Is this me again?
Think so.
Yeah!
Okay. Hi, I'm not smart. Hang on, I'm gonna drink some water.
You're very smart.
This means there's more of you now, and you more of you can experience the moth as Metaton experience.
Incredible. Oh, that human. Oh my god, this part. Could it be? My one true love?
Welcome to Metaton Free Undertale.
It's Romeo and Juliet now.
I completely forgot that this happens.
Same.
Come on,
are you making me sing?
Yes!
Please run away, Monster King. Forbids your stay. Humans must live far apart. Even if it breaks my heart. They'll put you in the dungeon. It'll suck. And then you'll die a lot. Really sad.
Really?
You're gonna die.
Sometimes even.
Cry, cry, cry. So sad it's happening.
That's beautiful.
Mom, that was glorious.
Yeah. Thanks. So sad. So sad that you are going to the dungeon. Well, toodles.
I guess we're going to the dungeon.
Oh, damn! You're in the dungeon!
Oh, no. Whatever shall I do? My love has been cast away into the dungeon. A dungeon with a puzzle so dastardly, my paramour will surely perish. Am I doing the voice right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Oh, heavens, have mercy. The horrible colored tile maze.
That's it.
Each colored tile has its own sadistic function.
Yeah, we've all heard it before.
For example, a green tile sounds a noise, and then you must fight a monster. Red tiles will... Actually, wait a second. Didn't we see this puzzle about 100 rooms ago? That's right, you remember all the rules, don't you? Great, then I won't waste your time repeating them. Oh, and you'd better hurry. Because if you don't get through in 30 seconds...
Oh, good.
Oh.
You'll be incinerated by these jets of fire.
Where did you get these jets of fire?
Magic! Don't worry about it.
This is where my funding comes from!
My poor love, I'm so filled with grief I can't stop laughing. Good luck, darling. Now in tears, we all will drown. Colored tiles, make them a fool. If only they still knew the rules. Well, that was a sorry try. Now let's watch them fry. Hey, fried! Ooh, I'm so sorry. Looks like you're out of time.
I wonder if anyone actually is able to make it across the whole thing.
Yeah, I wonder if it's possible. Oh no.
Here come the flames, darling. They're closing in.
You won't be able to kill me, same as all the others.
You can't kill me in a way that matters. Getting closer. Oh my. Any minute now.
Watch out! I'll save you. I'm hacking into the firewall right now. I get it.
Barely the firewall.
Oh no! How could this happen?
Unlike you, I have friends.
Foiled again by the brilliant Dr. Alphys.
He's yes. really you, good at that.
You guys are so subtle. I love you.
That's right. Metaton, give up already. You'll never be able to defeat us with the power of friendship. Yeah. Not as long as we work together. Your puzzle's over. Now go home and leave us alone.
A puzzle? Over? Alphys, darling, what are you talking about? Did you forget what the green tiles do? They make a sound, then you have to fight a monster. Well, darling, that monster is me.
Not really following the speech medicine.
Yep, I don't have any healing things I'm willing to use. Yay!
Oh no.
This is it, darling. Say goodbye. Is that your phone? You'd better answer it.
Hey, this seems bad, but don't worry. There's one last thing I installed on your phone. You see that yellow button? Go to this phone's axe menu and press it.
The phone is resonating with Metaton's presence.
Oh, that yellow glow.
Now proceed.
Oh. Oh. You've defeated me. How can this be? You are stronger than I thought, etc. Was that good? Was that good?
Yes, that was very good.
Looks like you beat him. You did a really great job out there.
Huh. Ab says, I like to think that this is actually a really basic form of the same bullet magic that monsters all use intuitively. Would make sense. All thanks to you.
What? Oh, no, I mean... You were the one doing everything cool. I was just a guy in the chair.
So?
I just wrote some silly programs for your phone. Hey, this might sound strange, but... Can I tell you something? Before I met you, I didn't really like myself very much. For a long time, I felt like a total screw-up. Like, I couldn't do anything without ending up letting everyone down. But guiding you has made me feel a lot better about myself. So, thanks for letting me help you. Anyway, we're almost to the cult. It's just past MTT Resort. Come on, let's finish this.
I wonder what that stands for.
Gee, I wonder also.
I could never guess.
As to the question of whether there's going to be Metaton in this run, apparently yes.
So much Metaton.
I love when Metaton.
Yes. Hey, it's you again. Business is excellent here. These two fellows bought all my ice cream. I've actually sold out of everything. Sorry. Wait, I've still got something for you. A big smile. How about that? Thanks.
I think that should have put a big smile into our inventory. I think that would be funny.
I love them.
They're
They're bros.
Bros. In love.
They're bros and they're in love.
They love a bro.
Hey, hey, did you remember my name?
What?
You remember?
I love how she doesn't ask you.
Yeah. How could I be so easily defeated? I'll always remember that you remembered.
Oh. Oh. That face.
Wait, hold on.
What?
I'm just trying to... Okay, so this is where we initially were, then we fell down
here. Yes,
it's
up. Yeah.
Those are just random houses.
Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about
it. The layout of this world, does it work?
Hey, is this where the fucking the alley cats are?
Oh! Close, I think?
I don't know what those are.
No, it's further. It might be further. It might be one further.
Hey.
It might be outside the palace.
I heard you're going to the core.
This is where the Burger Cat is!
Oh!
How about grabbing some dinner with me first?
Yeah. This is where the Millennial Burger Cat is!
Great, thanks for treating me. Over here, I know a shortcut.
Hello.
Well, here we are. So, your journey's almost over, huh? You must really want to go home. Hey, I know the feeling, buddo. Though, maybe sometimes it's better to take what's given to you. Down here, you've already got food. Drink, friends, is what you have to do really worth it? Forget it. I'm rooting for you, kid.
Cryptic.
Hey, let me tell you a story. So I'm a sentry in Snowden Forest, right? I sit out there and watch for humans. It's kind of boring. Fortunately, deep in the forest, there's this huge locked door, and it's perfect for practicing knock-knock jokes. So one day, I'm knocking him out, like usual. I knock on the door and say, knock-knock, and suddenly, from the other side, I hear a woman's voice. Who's there? So, naturally, I respond, dishes. Dishes who? This is a very bad joke. Then she just howls with laughter. Like it's the best joke she's heard in 100 years. So I keep coming, and she keeps laughing. She's the best audience I've ever had. Then, after a dozen of them, she knocks and says, knock knock. I say, who's there? Old lady. Old lady who? Oh, I did not know you could yodel. Wow. Needless to say, this woman was extremely good. We kept telling each other jokes for hours. Eventually, I had to leave. Papyrus gets kind of cranky without his bedtime story. But she told me to come by again, and so I did. Then I did again, and again. It's a thing now. Telling bad jokes through the door. It rules.
Hey, friend.
One day, though, I noticed she wasn't laughing very much. I asked her what was up. Then she told me something strange. If a human ever comes through this door, could you please promise something? Watch over them and protect them, will you not? No, I hate making promises. And this woman, I don't even know her name, but someone who sincerely likes bad jokes, has an integrity you can't say no to. Do you get what I'm saying? That promise I made to her. You know what would have happened if she hadn't said anything? Buddy. You'd be dead where you stand.
Holy shit.
Hey, lighten up, Blecko. I'm just joking with you. Besides, haven't I done a great job of protecting you? I mean, look at yourself. You haven't died a single time. Hey, what's that look supposed to mean? Am I wrong? Heh. Well, that's all. Take care of yourself, kid. Because someone really cares about you.
Do you ever think about how that guy is a sex symbol?
For good reason!
I try not to. I also try not to.
For good reason!
Is it?
Yes! I have died like 2 or 3 times. And Sans is very emotionally sexy, fuck you.
I think he's an interesting character.
Listen, I'm just saying that most people don't look at the skeleton man and go, you know what? He needs a giant 2-foot-long glowing dick.
Glad to know we all see the same fan art.
Would make sense. Yeah, I've died like a handful of times because this game is difficult. Originally, we dug mazes with puzzles in order to foil human attacks, but now, building things winding and confusing, it's some awful tradition. You can't go, 2 feet without being up to your armpits in puzzles.
Oh.
I work at the core. The inside is a maze made of swappable parts. That means we can shuffle the layout at will.
I want to clarify, I absolutely respect.
That's how IKEA works.
Respect the grind, and yeah. Then the sand sex symbol, and then the 2 feet glowing dick. Like, yes, go for it.
See, the 2 foot glowing penis is an add-on. I find him sexy the way he is.
Without the modification.
But also, it does mean that the ranked competitive sex meme is basically just when people ship versions of papyrus with each other.
Competitive sex.
Have you not seen the ranked competitive sex meme?
No, I have. It's just funny every time I think about it.
Fair. Boy, was today a fun day. I sure love puzzles.
Enemies to lovers.
This guy's a moth and a bird. I'm a comedian. I'm very funny. People laugh at my jokes. Now, my son, he wants to be a comedian like his father.
Like his father!
Like his father, but his jokes ain't funny. He tells these awful puns. He's an embarrassment to our family.
Didn't we fight him, like, a few weeks ago?
Yes, we did.
That's not funny. Since his mother passed on, he couldn't stand living at home anymore. So he ran away. I haven't seen him since. I'm a terrible father. Ha ha. It's not funny.
Is this a Seinfeld joke? Blub blub blub. You'll have to reserve a table to eat here.
I love the way your voice shifted as soon as the accent came out in text. You're like, I got this.
I've done this accent before.
You'll also need to reserve your chair, your silverware, your food, your... Okay.
I hate it when that happens.
Look at the carpet.
I am, like, 30% sure that if you go, like, out of here and around back, the alley cats will be there.
Alley cats might be here. Oh, to the right.
To the right, yeah.
Yeah.
See, I told you.
Oh, adorable.
Oh!
The stuff inside is, like,
totally wicked.
Totally wicked.
But, like, the stuff we found is, like,
totally wicked cheap.
You should, like, totally wicked buy all of it?
Oh my god.
I'm delighted.
I mean, like, where did get guns or food or
we found it in the garbage.
I love them so much.
It's good, like, garbage.
Really, really good garbage.
I'm just gonna read this bit of chat out loud. He doesn't have a 2 foot glowing penis, he just fucks you with a gaster blaster. Also Sans is sad, okay? Fuck.
Are you saying sad people can't fuck? Are you saying us depressed bastards can't get it on? Where do we get the garbage? Like, the garbage store, duh! I waterfall mostly!
This is delightful, I'm so happy!
Oh my god! Metaton!
actually like my robot husband. I think we're both going to marry him. He just like know it yet.
I'm so happy.
So like Dr. Alphaspit Metaton, like,
right?
What they tell you. But like Metaton always acts like
it was his idea somehow.
And even right after he was built, like
Alphys was an old friend.
But they're like not friends anymore.
Unlike me and Braddy, best friends forever. She really should be forever.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, Metaton!
Actually,
we've been doing the husband thing again.
Tell our robot husband.
I did not mean to do this one again.
No. It has the question marks. It tricks you.
Yeah. Yeah. Metaton? Old?
Question mark.
It's because Metaton is old.
Oh my god, Alphys!
Wait, hold on. This is a joke. Sleep isn't the Sands. He's the Metaton.
Yeah.
Oh, so god. Right.
I love Sleep so much.
He used to live on our street. I mean, like, if your big sister. She just the coolest places to find trash.
She was these weird cartoons.
And she became the royal scientist.
Yes! We haven't seen her in forever.
Pastor.
So Alpha's always like.
Asgore is a super cutie.
Super cutie. So, like, I'm pretty sure she
made Metaton to, like, totally impress him.
A robot with a soul!
That's, like, super relevant to his hobbies.
So, after seeing Metaton, Asgore
asked her to do all the science stuff for him. But nobody's, like, seen anything from her yet.
Or her at all!
Like, just stay in her lab all day.
Like, live a little, girl!
Yeah, like,
Oh my god, he's a total goober.
He's like,
I love that guy. God, we're like so hyped for the destruction of humanity.
Oh my god, yes. Yes.
I am delighted. I am so happy.
This is so good.
Raffy, we're gonna be rich.
Yeah, no, this is the best food source. If you're doing pacifist.
Do you guys know what the mystery key leads to?
I've done it before, but I don't remember. Oh, is it the little sands bunker?
Hello, Oma Romar. 5011, and welcome to the chat. I am good at reading out loud usernames.
that was really bad.
Uh huh. Yeah, bruh is a valid response. I also had to. I had to physically move my face closer to my screen to read it.
It's okay. It was more seductive that way.
Ooh, baby.
ASMR.
Oma Ramar? Is there anything back here?
No. But now we can talk to the relatable man.
The relatable man.
Mm-hmm. Apartment building turned hotel.
This man's made of
polygons.
Yeah, he's like origami.
He's got like four polygon tits.
I can't believe your tits are four polygons.
MIT Resort prides itself on being passed through.
What does the mystery key do?
I'm pretty sure. Oh, there's. Is that the little sounds bunker with like the picture and the machine in it?
Maybe.
Ooh, room service. Got my CT.
Excuse me.
Oh no, this guy's glooping.
If it's the same person in both places at once.
I'm not gonna be able to grind up the money for it, or like for using it, so but that makes sense. I will do that on a different run, maybe. Mostly right now I wanna get to the story.
Yeah, this run is for showing going the story.
Yeah, this run is for showing going the story.
I've never
the next
done
run
this
is...
before.
I feel like I didn't get the key to my genocide run.
Put.
You didn't have anything to put. Tragic.
Seems busy.
A sufficient effort.
That's like that robot that mops the floor.
I was literally just thinking about that.
You ever just are you ever just gooping?
I think about that robot all the fucking time.
Oh, you should. That's a slime. I'm outraged.
No clarification. Okay.
About. You know, that's how people on Tumblr talk.
That is true.
Yeah, I'm not gonna be home tonight. I think there's some cold pizza in my treasure hoard you can heat up. But the real treasure is you, honey.
You are my treasure hoard.
It's him!
It's him!
It's him!
I'm sorry. It's against the law to talk to customers who haven't bought anything. Customer is always right. I work food service.
You know what? I'm actually going to leave Burger Pants alone.
No! Talk
have
to
a
him!
A sparkler day.
How dare you not go through every single one of his dialogue options?
Because, first of all, I can't buy anything from him. And second of all, I don't want to bother him.
Yeah, his life is hard enough.
True.
We could make it worse.
That's for the
August,
genocide round.
Making things worse is not always the right move.
It's always sometimes the fun thing.
Sometimes things that are worse are worse.
You gotta press the buttons to find
prove
out what
it
happens.
Who are they? Nobody else is supposed to be here.
Shout out to, like, every Minecraft person who sees a button and is like, I wonder what that is, and immediately blows themselves up.
It gets me every single time.
I can't remember who did it during one of the life series, but I was so mad about it.
Well, we can't worry about that now.
Ominous. Ominous and fine.
Everything will be okay. Ready? This is it. Take the elevator up to the top of the core. Or fucking don't, I guess. I mean, what? The elevator should be working.
Use your hacking powers.
Well then, go to the right and keep heading up. I'll try to get into the system. I'm putting my glasses on top of
so
my
much,
glasses.
So much for the hacking powers.
Listen, fuck you. I can't do this under too much pressure.
Okay, I went right, and now there's fire?
No.
Right, now just keep heading up. That pit isn't on my map.
Every GPS.
Forget it! Let's
oh
try
my god.
Side.
Have I told you guys the story about the golf course?
No, did you drive through a golf course?
So I was trying to get to an appointment and I got off at the wrong bus stop. And I looked at like the bus schedule and I was like, there's no way I can get to this appointment on time if I actually wait for the bus. But this was like one bus stop off, and I was like, well, I'll just fucking walk there. So I pulled up Google Maps and I was like, okay, well, there's this big patch of green. I bet that's a park. I can cut through that and I can be there in like 5 minutes.
Oh no, no.
It was a golf course.
Historically not places.
And I don't know when to cut my losses. So I went down to the golf course and got lost.
Oh no.
And if you have ever been lost on a golf course, it is the most fucking embarrassing thing.
I would
because
be so
it is
brave.
So just like open, but it's all samey. And I was not supposed to be there, and it was clear I was not supposed to be there, so everyone was just kind of staring at me. And eventually I oriented myself enough to like hop a fence into like
not a golf
this
course.
Really posh street.
Oh my god.
It was like a couple blocks away from where my appointment was, and I eventually made it to the appointment.
Yeah,
it was awful. I was like,
yeah,
on the,
it was worth it.
I was on the golf course, the sun was beating down on me. I was like, I think I die here.
Me in infinite suburbia, like this hell looks like.
Anyway, yeah. I haven't learned my lesson.
No, it worked out great, is what I heard.
Yeah.
Okay. You should be able to make it through here.
This is like how once a friend of mine and I were trying to get to the Boston Common, and we wound up on the Esplanade, which, to be clear, those are not close nearby places.
Oh my god.
The Esplanade is that little playground, right? Or like it has a little playground?
Yeah, the Esplanade is the
watch out!
Is the long strip of grass on the edge of the Charles.
Yeah.
Oh!
Magic pops out of its hat.
Oh, sorry.
Yanks August earbud out. A violence and destruction, even.
The worst.
Magic.
Love this guy.
The jick is so angry.
One time in high school, I was waiting for my train, and I was trying to read my book, but it was, like, December, so the fucking bell ringers were there.
No.
And I couldn't focus, and eventually I got fed up, and I was like, well, my train's not gonna be here for, like, 2 hours. I'm gonna find somewhere else to read my book. So I went outside, and I, like, walked around until I found an appealing fence, and I hopped the fence, and then I just kind of like sat there and read my book until the security guard was like, you cannot be here. I also didn't learn my lesson then.
It's like, hop a fence, you'll have a new problem.
Yeah,
immediately. Whatever problem you have, it's a different one.
It was just like this.
Why are there so many monsters here?
They all
I mean, it's no problem, right? We've just got to keep heading forward.
Faye can back me up that I was just like this.
Yep. See also that time we got in trouble for being on a balcony in a library.
I don't remember that one.
Oh, yeah, no. So, my feelings on this incident have changed over time, but now I'm just delighted. We decided to go on a balcony in the Boston Public Library, and they were very upset at us.
I have no memory of this, but that sounds like something that we would do.
Exactly.
Once I tried this, I kind of half stowed away on a school bus, and then I got out and, like... And this is during recess and like sixth graders, and then all and sixth, and all the lunch ladies were looking for someone with a bright jean coat. So naturally, I took my bright jean coat and I shoved it up my shirt, and then abandoned it in the bathroom for 3 days.
Oh my god!
Unprovoked.
Yep.
you escaped. You're doing your grand great escape. Well, looks like you can't proceed until you hit the switch. But those lasers will activate when you do. Looks like they'll come in this order. Orange, orange, blue. Got it? Move until the third one.
Thanks, Elphys.
I'm sorry, I'm under so much pressure right now. This is not going according to plan. Oh my god, are you okay? I'm sorry, I gave you the wrong order. Everything's fine, okay?
No. Alpha.
Let's just keep it to the right.
There was this one building when I was in high school that like never kept its roof access locked. And so sometimes I just like go up there and hang out.
Amazing.
And one time I was having a bad day and I like missed lunch, so I had my entire lunch. So I went up there and I had like a picnic up there. Like I spread out my trench coat as if it was a picnic blanket.
That's so good.
Good.
Crossroads. Try heading to the right. Yeah, that's fair.
Oh god, the banana men are here.
Night night!
Oh. Adieu.
Oh god. Many people with many faces.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Fuck.
I don't think you're very good at this.
Close your eyes and accept the darkness as it washes over you.
Goodbye, night night.
Are you okay? Why didn't you head to the right? Come on, you trust me, don't you?
Yes, I trust you, probably.
More lasers. Okay, I won't mess around this time. I'll just deactivate the lasers and let you through. They're not turning off. I can't turn them off. It's okay. I have this under control. I'm going to turn off the power for that whole node. And then you can walk across. Okay, go.
I'm not very prone to trespassing, but reading out loud from chat, but my cousin once peed on a barbed wire fence without noticing the large camera and sign reading, "The FBI investigates any incidents surrounding the pipeline," and was deeply alarmed when I pointed those out to him.
We caused a government incident.
Okay, for a second I was like, huh, I didn't remember there were train whistles in the Undertale soundtrack. No, they're just a train whistle.
It's your train whistle.
Wait! Stop!
Oh god.
The power! It's turning itself back on! Damn, this isn't supposed to... I'm gonna turn it off again. When it turns off, move a little, and then stop. Okay? You won't get hurt.
Oh no.
Come on, double time it! Faster! Riskier, you can do it!
Yeah, like it telegraphs when it's about to happen, it's fine.
Yay!
See, I've got everything under control.
Actually,
everything is under control.
Yeah.
I was gonna say shout out to my favorite Boston incident, which Faye was also there for.
Oh no.
Which is when you know which one this is.
I don't think I do, but keep going.
We were on the subway and this random guy came up to us and was like, "Hey, do you want to see my sextant?"
Oh no.
And we kind of like hesitantly said yes, and he took out his literal actual sextant, which wasn't a euphemism, and it was actually really cool.
Yeah.
Thanks for measuring.
I'm curious what your favorite is.
My favorite what?
Boston incident.
Oh god. Unfortunately, this was not when you were there, but it was probably the time that I got an impromptu comedy a stand-up comedy routine on the Red Line at midnight.
Incredible.
That sounds like something that would happen on the Red Line at midnight.
That does sound like something that would happen.
I'm also curious what you thought I was gonna say.
I just honestly didn't know, but as soon as you said the Sextant incident, I was like, there was nothing else you could say.
Yeah, it's obviously the Sextant incident.
I mean, this was related to the fact that there was a period where for a while I was both talked to strangers way too much on the subway and also was talked to way too much by strangers on the subway. And thankfully that like weird magnetism has come down a lot, but there was that time where a guy told me that because a guy elaborately told me how kidnappable I was on the train, and that was very strange.
Oh my god, what?
I spent
a lot of time in Boston for like several years, and I was approached by strangers all of twice ever, except for when I was with Faye. When I was with Faye, we got approached constantly.
This is why I say that I'm I.
Yeah.
But like extremely non-consensually. It's very funny,
okay,
but also wild.
You should. I don't know. This doesn't look like my map at all. I'm sorry. I have to go.
Oh no.
Click.
East, the end.
Oh,
that's how you go inside the trash can. We can talk to Burger Pants.
Do I have the money for Burger Pants? I don't have the money. I can. All right.
Yeah.
Once we get to an elevator, I will talk to Burger Pants.
Yeah.
Love wins.
Final rocket.
This isn't even my final frogget.
I kill children.
Thank you for that.
I take souls.
Fear, fear. I'm so good at video games.
Yeah, you can bullet those hells. Bullet that hell.
Wait, how can it attack while asleep? Fuck off!
Surfing
no, the other
flag.
Guy's attacking.
Oh, yes. This is the part where you can really tell that he really, really liked Tuhu to the point of moving to Japan. Because, oh my god.
It's Tuhu? I thought it was Toho.
Or Toho. I am so good at pronouncing words that I only see written down.
Wait, that apple was for, right?
Yeah. Though the version
that's
with lyrics is it's like an updated version of the original, which is just video game music. Both the version with lyrics, which was I believe originally a Vocaloid song, and the original version are really good. I also highly recommend looking up people porting the Bad Apple video into more obscure things, such as Minecraft.
Ridiculous.
I really like the Minecraft one.
There's also a Super Mario one where you get damaged by any of the, like, black color. So it's Mario dodging around.
I've seen it in Desmond.
Around.
I've seen it in Desmond.
Oh, that sounds fun.
So here's truly... the thing. Sorry.
Oh, I'm just gonna say truly ever on and on, we do continue circling.
Yep.
So
here's the thing about Vocaloid is that it was a sort of hyperfixation for a very long time, and I keep dancing around what I'm sure will eventually become a absolutely brain-consuming Toho hyperfixation. It's just that I know if I ever Toho, I will never return.
That's such a mood. Like, sometimes I look at a thing and I'm like, I will hyperfixate on this. And, I get to choose when that happens, but I don't get to choose whether it happens.
Mm-hmm. Did you know they're coming out with a physical edition of Eve?
Oh, that's
no!
Cool. They just released the remaster, didn't they?
It's gonna be of the remaster.
Ooh. God, I love Eve.
Did they add anything in the remaster?
I don't know. I think it just looks nicer, maybe. Also, there's now a physical edition of Paradise Killer, and I want it.
Oh. They made plushies of that demon guy.
Wait, what?
I love it.
They made plushies. They had a little Kickstarter to make, or not Kickstarter, a little campaign to make plushies last summer. So honestly, the plushies didn't look very good, but
it was of Shinji.
Oh, that's always a shame.
Yeah.
It was kind of cute. A good plushie.
Me too.
This is a known fact about me.
Plushies are so good. I think more things should have plushie merch.
Agreed.
Yeah.
See that? I think Pearl put out plushies.
Yeah, they look cute. I got one of the Doc M77 goat plushies.
Oh.
So I have mine. Its name is Radium.
No!
He's friends. Oh no.
Oh, no.
Yes. And he's friends with my other goat plushie, whose name is Asbestos after the one that Anathema has.
My favorite screaming goat.
Yeah.
I really want a techno plushie.
Oh, I have a techno plushie. It's very good.
I have a stuffed pig that I asked for Christmas because I knew I couldn't get a techno plushie.
It's a very cute stuff thing.
It is a cute stuff thing.
You kneel and pray for safety. How knight of you.
Yes, very devout.
Oh, Gawain, you should look up specifically the Camelot arc of Fate Grand Order, because I think you would actually appreciate it a lot.
Ooh, I should. Is it, what medium is it?
It is a mobile game, and it is not worth the grind to get to, so just look up the, transcriptor on YouTube or something.
I'll do that.
But it includes, among other things, staying alive by the sheer power of depression.
Hell yeah. You can get pickled by depression.
It's a little bit counterproductive, but, I have so much spite, so I can understand.
Yeah.
It's just...
L! L! L!
I
look how
that, you're consistently nerfed by info dumping.
Yes.
I love how you've died twice through every single time we played this, and then just in today's session, you've
it's
doubled
of the
count.
It's because of the info dumping.
Yeah. My brain has too much autism in it.
Oh, I feel that.
Sometimes you are just autism.
I was working on the animatic I'm working on last night, and I could feel I literally had huge amounts of trouble putting my brain into any other mode. It's like titanic, like a physical effort to pay attention to anything else, even if it's something I should pay attention to that oven that I turned on.
Yeah.
I got running updates with the oven, it was very entertaining. Yeah. I was like, go eat food!
I did turn the oven both on and off at appropriate time.
I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
And anyway, the Orpheus Protocol.
And the animatic.
God, I love the Orpheus Protocol.
You've listened to enough of it that the animatic will make sense.
Oh, good. Okay. I haven't been listening to it because my brain has been like, no.
That's so
podcasts
valid.
Are illegal right now. And it makes me sad because I want to listen to more Orpheus Protocol and also catch up on Malevolent.
Yeah.
I should also catch up on Malevolent. Except
yeah, one of my roommates
is my brain is like, no,
is
because it sucks.
Listening to Malevolent now.
Resist urge to info dump.
Who's listening to Malevolent?
Oh, one of my roommates. He just met Kane, and very excited about it.
Fuck you. Fuck this. On Abra's your cadabras.
Hello.
Abra, fuck you!
Hello, Jebel Deltarune 212. I am well. I am, very good at bullet hell.
Yeah.
Oh, actually, as expert. We're here as debuffs.
Yeah, we distract and we do funny voices.
Otherwise, it would be too easy.
Yeah, we're for, like, distraction and stuff.
And funny voices.
And funny voices. Hey, August, I think you should play Frog Fractions 4.
What order should I play Frog Fractions?
Okay,
I feel
so
like the deal is
Listen. Listen, so there's Frog Fractions 1, that's the original.
Yes, I have played that one.
And then there's Frog Fractions 2, which is hidden in a completely unrelated game. Yeah. Frog Fractions 3 is the search for Frog Fractions 2, and Frog Fractions 4 is the Frog Fractions 1 DLC.
Ah, well, I can do that.
Beautiful.
It's in a fishing game, isn't it? The second one?
I don't know. I own the game that Frog Fractions 2 is in, but I haven't played it yet.
To fish until you...
Until you pull out the frog.
It's like Ben drowned, but like, you're not cursed. They did not fish up Ben drowned. But
I love Frog Fractions. So I have played Frog Fractions and Frog Fractions 4, and I guess technically Frog Fractions 3, but I haven't played 2 yet.
The soul missing frog.
I enjoy Frog Fractions a lot. It is the homestuck.
The other one. The other
Frog
one.
Fractions
okay.
Is iconic.
Working on the stigmatism.
Yes, the stigmatism wants you to bully. It's that. It's don't worry, don't think about it too hard.
I made August play Frog Fractions and it was great.
Good.
It was good. I enjoyed that stream.
Okay, so in fact, if I am not info dumping, I am actually significantly better at.
You did it!
Yeah, it's true. It's true.
Fate Grand Order didn't destroy it all this time.
Another thing that fate has tarnished.
Wait, hold on. I'm putting in special effort to go annoy Burger Pants.
Yes!
Just for August.
Yep.
We have to experience the game to its fullest.
Excellent.
This does mean that later there's going to be a lot of me walking through corridors.
Hey, it happens, it happens.
This is the time where you can tell us about fate.
Yeah.
Oh god, I don't know where to begin.
Burger Pants!
You can just get a 60G thing! You didn't-
Yeah.
Okay, but it's-
Okay!
Oh my god, his face. What? Why did you try to talk to me? I'll get in trouble if I get chummy with the customers. Sorry.
So, I wanted to be an actor. Take it from me, little buddy. I'm getting it on in years. Let me give you advice, little buddy.
Okay.
I like to imagine this guy is like 19.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, Emma's told me to start complaining about a specific event with no context, and so, to give the least amount of context possible, a bit character from a spin-off converts the god Eros to Christianity, and this causes problems. which we then have to solve by beating her up, and she turns into a baby as a reference to a video game you can only play in Japan, at which point the game endorses endorses piracy, and then you have to beat up the literal baby who is America themed for some fucking reason, and once again she converted the god Eros to Christianity, which in her mind is specifically the kind of Christianity where she specifically takes over the world as a benevolent dictator. Also, she is the daughter of a Catholic priest who is also Rasputin. I will not clarify.
Several.
I will just say this in my heart.
Fate has broken nearly all of its own internal rules, but the one that it hasn't broken is that gods cannot be summoned as servants except when possessing human beings. And this has caused so many problems. Also, half of said gods are possessing one character who has already gone through so much, she doesn't need to be possessed by multiple different gods.
Oh god.
There's also a version of her who is a trash compactor who stores garbage data in her boobs.
Excuse me?
I'm sorry, what?
That's someone.
I am.
Someone somewhere's into that.
That's too specific not to be.
M has a figure of this character, and I am kicking the explanation to them.
Please.
As a fan, it's your responsibility.
It's still got time to live like me. I'm 19 years old.
Oh my god!
Real life.
I was literally right.
Oh, yeah. I thought you were making a joke because he was canonically 19.
Listen.
I forgot.
So, save you a lot of trouble. Never interact with attractive people. Unless you're one of them. They're just going to take advantage of you. Like, that time two chicks asked me to sneak some glam burgers. And I, naive teenager that I was, said yes to them.
You are still a teenager.
Bad idea.
God, I love that this is the only good facial expression from this character.
So bad. Bad idea.
Though I feel this one in my heart.
So, I went out to the alley to see these two ladies and, see what happened next. Then my boss, saw me and he asked me what I was doing.
Yes, and we are talking about your beloved passive-aggressive trash compactor. Explain the trash compactor who stores trash in her boobs.
I was so startled the hamburgers in my pocket tumbled out onto the ground. Not wanting to lose face, I scrambled to pick them up. But as I was leaning over, the weight of the remaining hamburgers caused my pants to fall down. Then the girls left. Everyone calls me Burger Pants now.
I'm gonna read out loud Amethos' comments as they come. Passion Flip sucks so bad and I love her.
Passion Flip?
The passion is for the storing trash in her boobs.
Yeah.
She is an AI that inexplicably looks like a different character for basically no reason.
It's beautiful. Sometimes you need those so you can reuse assets, maybe.
Yeah.
When I first came to Hotland, it was my dream to work with Metaton.
She's named after a flower because all the AIs are.
No, good.
To be fair, she does look like Sakura, who's also named after a flower.
Well, be careful what you wish for, little buddy. God, have you even looked around? This place is a labyrinth of bad choices. And every day there's a fountain that pisses on the carpet out there. Every time we try to change something for the better, he vetoes it and says that's not how they do it on the surface.
Yeah, you gotta make it bad on purpose.
Terrible at her.
She's made out of the bits of her code that her evil MILF robot didn't want.
She's like, fucking Liquid Snake from Metal Gear. A snake, I only have the recessive genes. It's not how anything works, but okay. Oh, right. Humans are always eating hamburgers made of seeds and glue. Why do people find him so attractive?
because I voice him and I fuck at it.
Literally true. He is literally just a freaking rectangle. No, one time I bought one of those kits online to make yourself more rectangular. It didn't work.
Everyone knows that squares are the sexiest shape.
This means she's a passive-aggressive weirdo who doesn't understand that everyone hates her because she's passive-aggressive at them. Actually, you know what? Snakes comparison valid because, like snakes, there's multiple Sakura face bots, and they mostly do not like each other. To be clear, Sakura in the original game is a love interest where if you pursue her, the world explodes. Because she's so traumatized that she deserves a little cannibalism as a treat.
If you date her, she gets so traumatized the world explodes. I feel like that's a protagonist problem.
No. She's already so traumatized. It's just that if you date her, she becomes the physical manifestation of her trauma physically manifests.
Damn.
And then you eat her?
No, and then she eats people.
Oh, and then she eats you.
And then she basically, as soon as the author didn't have to make it a porn game anymore, instead of being really horny, she just wanted to drink blood a lot.
Hell yeah.
Wait, Fate's a porn game?
Yes! They had to make it a porn game so they could sell, because their first game also had to be a porn game so it could sell. And then as soon as they didn't have to be a porn game anymore...
Arthur needs to be hot!
Arthur needs to have massive titties that she needs to fuck so much. I guess.
Everything I learned about this franchise feels like a lie.
I will explain Fate in more detail later with diagrams.
I mean, like, okay. I believe you. Have another friend who's into it. I believe her also. But, like, do I really?
We should have, like, a PowerPoint party.
Yeah. Fate PowerPoint.
My Fate PowerPoint will involve such sentences as, the magical girl spinoff that is bad. I'm going to read out loud this out of context Nasu porn quote, freshly boiled pussy, and then we're going to move on like I never said that.
No. No, that's not what you're supposed to do with it. Future? What future? Nothing down here ever changed. I'll probably be trapped at this stupid job forever.
Fun fact about the genocide route, he is.
Oh wait, there's one thing that keeps me going. If Asgore gets just one more soul, we'll finally get to go to the surface. It'll be a brand new world. There's gotta be a second chance out there for me. For everyone. So stay strong, little buddy. When I make it big, I'll keep you in mind.
This is just what being 19 is like.
Yep. I'm gonna talk to Hand Lady.
Yes, we know. Because of this incident, rooms are running at a special rate. 200 gold a room. Interested? Do let us know if you change your mind. Have a sparkular day.
Not even spectacular, just sparkular. Spectacular is cooler.
Have a sparkular day.
Alright, now that I have a captive audience because I'm walking through a bunch of empty corridors, I'm going to explain Fate. So, to actually do it in a way that is somewhat coherent, Fate started out as an H game in the late 2000s based on the two, on the author and the artist's OCs from when they were in high school. Functionally, it would be like
this could be us.
Yes, functionally it's like if, for marketability reasons, we decided to gender swap, Riven and basically what the equivalent is it's an alternate universe where Riven was a girl and Sam and Asling were boys, and then we decided to gender swap them for marketability reasons. And then also instead of and so it's like half like really interesting world building and like really heartfelt narratives about like choice and what it means to be a hero and like coping with the effects of abuse, and half the author is ambushing you in and dark alleyway and explaining his lore to you via PowerPoint.
And also,
there's boobs.
Also, there's boobs.
And also, there's boobs.
The artist would send. And the artist would send. The artist basically would send Nasu out of context porn scenes, and then he would have to fit them in the story somehow.
Oh. Make this make sense! Go, go, go!
Writing challenge. Make my assets.
So functionally, there are three main routes because it's the three main routes, and these conveniently have been adapted into three main anime adaptations are: you date Saber, who's King Arthur but a girl, and it's you follow your ideals, you save everybody, you kiss the girl, and she like finally is able to live a life as a teenage girl instead of as literally a king. There's you date the popular girl at school, and things get very, very weird very, very quickly. And then in the third route, it's your really close friend who is the older the little sister of this shitty guy that you're sort of friends with, turns out to have been like horrifically abused for most of her life and finally is able to lash out. But the problem is that since she is also carrying around a lot of very problematic magic, her being able to feel things emotionally leads to basically the world burning down, and then you have to, Tom Lin her until the world stops burning down. Mm-hmm. Also, everyone and everything in this Fate is extremely gender, because there's still a tendency to gender swap historical male figures into women. It's just that the explanations get both lazier and lazier and more and more trans.
Love this for them.
The other problem is that, or maybe not problem, but the other thing about Fate is that instead of keeping all of the spin-offs in like narrative continuity with each other, most of the spin-offs exist in their own separate universes. Also, they've decided to make pretty much everything the author ever wrote in the 90s in continuity with Fate. Beautiful. Which means that they retroactively inserted his OC who has two personalities who are equally obsessed with this guy and is really good at swords in the same universe as Fate. Sometimes you have a male alter who is also really, really, really obsessed with the guy you like. And you kill monsters.
Oh, yes.
And solve crime.
There you are, darling. It's time to have our little showdown. It's time to finally stop the malfunctioning robot. Not malfunction, reprogramming, get real. This was all just a big show. An act. Alphys has been playing you for a fool the whole time.
Oh no.
Oh right, one final thing before I stop the hyperfixation so I can actually play this video game again. And then the male alter dies tragically for your mutual boyfriend, but it's fine because he still exists in your dreams and stuff.
That's... I love Fate.
As she watched you on the screen, she grew attached to your adventure. She desperately wanted to be a part of it. So she decided to insert herself into your story. She reactivated puzzles. She disabled elevators. She enlisted me to torment you. All so she could save you from dangers that didn't exist. All so you would think she's the great person. And that she's not. And now, it's time for her finest hour. At this very moment, Alphys is waiting outside the room. During our battle, she will interrupt. She will pretend to deactivate me, saving you one final time. Finally, she'll be the heroine in your adventure. You'll regard her so highly, she'll even be able to convince you not to leave. Or not. You see, I've had enough of this predictable charade. I have no desire to harm humans. Far from it, actually. My only desire is to entertain. After all, the audience deserves a good show, don't they?
I feel called out.
And what's a good show? Without a plot twist.
The real truth now.
Hey, what's going on? The door just locked itself.
I love this calculator-looking motherfucker. Sorry, folks. The old program's been canceled. But we've got a finale that will drive you wild. Real drama, real action, real bloodshed. On our new show, Attack of the Killer Robot.
Oh boy.
I was the one that hired everyone to kill you. That, however, was a short-sighted plan. You know what would be 100 times better? Killing you myself!
Yeah, to your rating.
Double vanilla. Wait, don't you understand what acting is?
Metaton. Ton.
Listen, darling, I've seen you fight. You're weak. If you continue forward, Asgore will take your soul. And with your soul, Asgore will destroy humanity.
Pirates. Space invaders.
But if I get your soul, I can stop Asgore's plan. I can save humanity from destruction. Then, using your soul, I'll cross through the barrier and become the star I've always dreamed of being. Hundreds, thousands, no, millions of humans will watch me.
Buddy, you can't even get that many monsters to watch you.
Cause they're all dead!
Glitz! Glamour! I'll finally have it all! So what if a few people have to die? That's show business, baby!
So true, gang.
I can't see what's going on in there, but don't give up, okay? There's one last way to beat Metaton. This is a work in progress, so don't judge it too hard. But you know how Metaton always faces forward because this is an RPG? That's because there's a switch on his backside. So you can turn him around, and press the switch. He'll be vulnerable. Well, gotta go.
Oh, a mirror? Right, I have to look perfect for our grand finale. I don't see it. Where is it? Did you just flip my switch?
Oh no.
Oh, yes! Oh my! If you flipped my switch, that can only mean one thing. You're desperate for the premiere of my new body. How rude. Lucky for you, I've been aching to show this off for a long time.
Oh my god.
This is so trans.
Yeah.
So, as thanks, I'll give you a handsome reward. The reward is me, I'm handsome. I'll make your last living moments absolutely beautiful.
And yet, for some reason, I find Sans hotter. I don't know why.
Yeah, it's funny because this version of Metaton is like designed to be sexy, and everyone was like, no, I want the short skeleton.
In too hard.
He's doing his best.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Metaton.
Drama, romance, bloodshed.
Done.
I'm the idol everyone craves.
Violence.
I am. This is probably one of the parts of the game that I am the worst at.
This is complicated.
Oh my god, the eating garbage lowered the ratings. Smile for the camera. Oh, it's time for a pop quiz. I hope you brought a keyboard. This one's an essay question. Beautiful. Why don't you write a book? Right, because I'm going to kill you. Your essay really showed everyone your heart. Why don't I show you mine?
Oh my god.
Metaton.
Ooh, I'm just warming up. But how are you on the dance floor? Can you keep up the pace?
I don't know how to deal with that.
Yeah, that one seems kind of impossible.
Lights, camera, bombs. Things are blowing up.
Metaton, you're just throwing things into make a cohesive show.
Smells like Metaton.
Time for our union-regulated break.
When he's going, he just goes faster and Rachel goes faster and faster.
We've grown so distant, darling. How about another heart-to-heart?
Oh no.
Metaton.
That face.
He's having a great time.
Arms? Who needs arms with legs like these? I'm still going to win.
Metaton saying, never skip leg day.
Yeah.
Come on. The show must go on. Drama! Action! Light! Camera! Enough of this! Do you really want humanity to perish? Or do you just believe in yourself that much?
I've gotten this far.
Mm.
Oh no.
I'm gonna have to start over by the metaton.
We've also been going for a couple hours, I think.
Yeah, so this might be a good place to take a... It can end now, but only
for... It can end now.
We'll be back next week. We'll be back next week. I feel so bad. I was doing so well.
You were doing great.
All right, well, that's it.
Yeah.
Bye, everyone.
Bye, everyone. Admire the goat for a few seconds.
Goat time.
Love a goat.
Goat.
Have fun, everyone.
Goat.
Good night.
Oh,
please follow me if you haven't already.
Yeah.
Good night.